Welcome again to my class, and I am Chef Aditya Saxena. So today we would be covering the next three principles of indenting. Now in previous video we have learned the principle of indenting. The first principle was yield of a product, and today we would be learning about the next three principles, namely type of event, regional influence and the service style. So in today's video, we will be covering the three principles with some more additional topics, that is challenges of volume cooking, difficulties faced during indenting for volume feeding, and factors affecting purchasing procedures. Now the second principle for indenting is the type of event. What is the type of event in which, for which we are indenting? And at this point, another thing is, the type of event for which the food is required also plays a major role for indenting. When the variety is more, the quantity consumed will be less, comparatively less, and the most guests would like to taste most of the varieties. Now with this I mean, if we are indenting for a large, you know, catering business or for a wedding, and we had to indent less. And why is that? Because, you know, there would be different varieties of food. So there would be Chinese, there would be Oriental cuisine, there could be Indian, there could be Mexican, Middle Eastern, depending upon the menu. Supposedly, if the menu has around 40-50 dishes and it has been cooked on buffet, and whenever the guests would be going to the buffet, they would definitely think that they would let them taste each and every dish. So they would be tasting each and every dish spoon by spoon. So on in general, a person consumes around 250 to 300 grams of food in a single meal. At max it can go to, you know, around 400 grams if a person eat more. So if you calculate it like that, the consumption of each and every dish would be less. So for that we would be indenting less. If we talk about a la carte, that definitely there would be much more indenting, because the food portion size would be small and people will tend to have more. Again, in buffets, if there is no big elaborate buffet, then the food items in buffet is really less. So people will tend to eat more because they know the buffet is not a big one. They will generally go for more of rice, vegetables, dals, and any non-veg item that would be there. So the type of event also, you know, determines the amount of intent that we had to do. Either it could be less if the buffet is more, or it could be more if the buffet is less. It's vice versa. Next is regional influence. Now, regional food also plays an important role in deciding the intenting for a particular item. Now, for example, people of Bengal would love to eat seafood, while people from North India would prefer chicken or a mutton. Now for an instance, let's take an example. Some of us are attending a wedding in North India, particularly in Punjab. And they are also serving Bengali food or food from Orissa. So what we Punjabis or the people over there in wedding, what they'll do is they'll taste it little by little. They won't take it much because the food, the taste is not being familiarized by the people in North or in Punjab. So they won't take their chances. What they will eat more is a dish which they are familiar, like butter chicken, chicken tikka masala, chicken masala. So they would be eating much more of those things or the vegetable part instead of eating more of a Bengali or a Odia food. So the indenting for those food would be less, whereas the indenting for the food which is regional to that particular area would be more. So this is how regional influence the indenting part for the chefs. The next is serving style. Now the style of service, whether buffet or a la carte, also determine the indenting and the portion size of a dish. Now the a la carte need less of indenting, as I have told, whereas the buffet or TDS, table d'hote, bulk of indenting, because there we are cooking food in bulk. Now again, in cooking food in bulk has a different catch in it, as the amount of dishes increase or decrease in a buffet, the indenting also increases and decreases in the buffet. Whereas in a la carte, the portion size is fixed. Suppose a guest has ordered for a particular food, he would be getting a fixed portion. He won't be getting a free hand to get a refill even after, just like they do in buffets. Whereas in buffet, the guest has a free hand. They can take whatever they can as many times as they can. So the indenting for some items in buffet is being done more than comparing to few other items. So this is how service style, you know, influence the indenting. Next is the challenge of volume cooking. What are the challenges that has been faced during volume cooking? The first is the perishability of product. The food products get perished easily, they can get ruined easily. So this is a challenge. The more fresher food you process and cook is much more tastier, instead of preparing a day or 2 days before the event. The second is the unpredictability of the volume business, that is your sales instability. You have no idea in a party how many guests would be coming. Supposedly a guest has told that I would be hosting a party for 300 people and you had made food for 300 people. And in during the party, you came to know that only 200 people has came. That's the food for 100 people has got, you know, wasted. So that is an unpredictability of volume business. The next is the unpredictability of menu mix that we have just covered in the previous slide, the wide choice of menu. When the menu is wide, the indenting would be less. People will tend to eat less. They will try to go and eat each and everything and taste each and everything. Whereas when there are less of food products on the buffet, they will eat more. The next is shorter cycle of catering. Now, the faster way for purchase, process and deliver of final product. Now, the catering business is, you know, the catering cycle is short cycle. They purchase instantly, they process it and they deliver the final product on time. It is for the caterers who are not operating within the hotel premises. They are individual independent caterers. They don't have that much big storage facilities available to them. So their operation cycle is quite, you know, short. They instantly purchase things, they process it, they make it, and then they deliver it. The next is departmentalization. Again, this is a big challenge for volume cooking. There is a need of coordination in that. Now, how would be different departments would be coordinating? A function prospectus is generated whenever a function is been organized in a hotel. A copy of function prospectus has been delivered to each and every outlet, each and every department actually. Front office, housekeeping, service, kitchen, maintenance. All the departments knows that what kind of service, what kind of function is been happening in which banquet, what are the number of pax, what are their duties during the function, and they all do it on regular basis. And this is a challenge because there are a lot of departments, there are a lot of functions that happen during a single day. So keeping an eye on them is a big bit of a challenge. Next is the difficulties faced during indenting. Now, storage space is a difficulty. If you don't have a storage space, you won't be able to indent for more or for a bigger party. Then an unpredictable footfall. You have no idea how much guests would be coming. You have been promised to that 300 guests would be there, but again, the guests are not up to the mark. Either it could be 200 or it could be more than 300. There could be shortage of food. There could be a food left over. So that is a difficulty. Location of event is also a difficulty that we have just talked about, the different, the regional influence. The location sometimes are inaccessible or it is not that much at per convenience. So food can get spoiled, which is the next point, the spoilage of food items with shorter lifespan. Those food items which have shorter lifespan, they can get spoiled either on buffet or during the traveling time if the catering is been there outside the premises. Then the transportation of food is again a problematic thing. Now the atmosphere or the temperatures are not so accessible or not so, you know, friendly sometimes. So the food can get ruined during transportation, or there could be other things, like a foreign object could be could fall down in the food and can, you know, ruin it or spoil it. Or there could be a mixing of different food items. Supposedly dal has been spilled into a vegetable, dry vegetable dish, or rice has fallen into dal, or it could be chicken that has been fallen into a vegetable thing. So these are the problems that is being faced generally during transportation of food. Next is your factors affecting purchasing procedure. What are the factors? The type of establishment, the bigger establishment, the catering establishments, those who cook in bulk, they purchase more raw material, whether as in a la carte, they purchase less of the raw materials. Again, service of operations and service. A buffet will have generally more of indenting, whereas in a la carte it would be less. Type of function will also determine what kind of function it is. Either it is for kids, it is for older age people, or it is for a corporate event. People tend to eat as per the function. The more sophisticated function, the lesser the people eat. Storage space availability, again, it is a factor. If you don't have that much storage space, you won't be able to purchase that much amount of food or raw material. Next is geographical location. Again, geographical location plays an important part. Supposedly your food outlet is in Kashmir and you are serving some of the food which is from South India, you won't be able to get those things over there. So again, that is a part of, you know, a geographical location which affects your purchasing procedure. You won't be getting the fresh fish or the fresh ingredients of Kerala that you would be serving over there. Next is the financial aspect. Again, if you don't have that much amount of money or finance or hard cash with you, you won't be able to purchase some of the food products. No doubt you would be having a credit line with you, but again, there are limitations for those things also. The last is skills of employee. Now, this is one of the most important topic, or one of the most important part. If your employee is not skilled enough to handle the, you know, purchasing procedure, or to handle the purchases or indenting, you will always be, you know, running out of money, or you will always end up paying more money for the things that you can buy in lesser term. So the employee should be skilled enough to know how much he had to purchase and how he had to purchase and from where he had to purchase. So this is what we have covered today, and I hope you have enjoyed the session. As of now, this is Chef Aditya Saxena signing out from Chitkara School of Hospitality. Thank you very much for attending the session.